गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून
हाँ गुड आफ्टरनून सर। तो हाँ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओपन फॉग रेफरेंस आर्किटेक्चर एंड देन ग्रीन कंप्यूटिंग इन फॉग एनवायरनमेंट। सो हियर वी हैव ए स्ट्रक्चर दैट नवेडेज ओके सो ड्यू टू द आईओटी इज ड्राइविंग बिजनेस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन बाय कनेक्टिंग एवरीडे ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड डिवाइसेस टुगेदर एंड क्लाउड होस्टेड सर्विसेस। सो दिस करेंट एनवायरनमेंट So the model emphasizes mandatory cloud connectivity, which is not feasible in real-time situations. So here, the current architecture support cannot sustain the projected velocity and volume requirement of IoT. To sustain IoT momentum, the open fog environment is defined a new architecture that can address infrastructure and connectivity challenges by emphasizing information processing closer to the where the data is being produced or used. So this approach is called this fog environment. So this open fog architecture represents a shift from traditional closed system and reliance on cloud-focused models to a new computational model that moves computation near to the edge and potentially right up to the IoT sensors and actuators of the network based on workload requirement and device capability. This is called fog nodes. There are not completely fixed to the edge, but should be seen as fluid system of connectivity. So in this context, we are having different gateways. So user layer where IoT user and end user application. So next this proximity network, and here we are having physical entities. And these physical entities are connected to the IoT gateway, and we have public network that is peer cloud, and this peer cloud is connected with the edge services and the end users application. So then these end users applications and end edge services are connected with device registry and device management, device identity service, API application, virtually IoT transformation and connectivity. So what are the things we are having? This virtualization connectivity, process management, and this data is connected with the database where transformation and connectivity will be happen. So here in this open fog invites open participation from across the industry, academia and non-profit organization which have an interest in the emerging IoT landscape. So normally this open fog instructs to harmonize with other grouping include that is not only limited that is also industrial internet consortium and mobile edge computing, open connectivity foundation and open NV. So here the various applications having in this open fog, so that these open fog deployments are logically hierarchically in nature from information processing point of view. So here in hierarchy we are having we start with the operational support and ends with decision support processing. And fog architecture, this open fog architecture is applicable across many different vertical market, including transportation, agriculture, smart cities, smart buildings, hospitality, and other areas, and provides business values for IoT applications that require low latency or network constraint. So here, what is the main pillar of OpenFog architecture? That is, it uses a multitude of computational client or edge devices, and this may operate on concert with associate cloud services to carry out storage, compute, network communication, and associated management tasks optimized based on the workload requirement. So here we are having the different layers. So in this case, if you see this one, this is the for edge computing. So what is the meaning of edge computing? That is the distributed computing paradigms that brings computation and data storage closer to the location where it is needs to improve response time and bandwidth. So these are the different areas where we can use edge computing, that is the edge gateway that will be between connected railway system, mobiles, and then connected cars. And we are having edge gateway server, that is connected with smart building, smart grids, connected track, and we are having the big data center, cloud data center, and connected wind turbines, connected aisle platforms, and smart street lights. And so all these are connected with the edge gateway servers, okay, which is nearest to the this one. So the Cisco mentioned that we are having the local devices, that is local data collection, and it is goes to the fog layer where the local data analysis and filtering process will be complete. And we are having real-time data auctions and storage of data. So this is the different way that we are having different edge, and what is the difference between the edge and fog environment? That industrial IoT data processing stack layer, this one. So here we are having the edge layer. We are having the edge layer where the applications are having. So the large volume real-time data processing at the source, where it is data virtualization and industrial PCs and embedded system gateways, micro data storage. So these are the different, this is at the level of edge layer. When you are coming to the fog layer, we are having local network where we can compute the data analysis and reduction, control response, virtualization. And so here individual edge nodes are connected with the fog servers and fog nodes, and that fog nodes are connected with the cloud layer where we can work on the business analytics and different data process. So if you are compute the data from your site, that is if you are taking the macro data storage or you are taking the your PC, so what happened when you are computing some data, it will be reached to the cloud layer, and it will gather the information from the fog layer, that cloud layer, and then they will complete the process. So here what happened, we are introduced the edge layer and fog layers so that the processing speed and that response time is increased, means it will be your process will be completed within a minimum time of span. So here the objective that cloud cannot be cope with all data. So here the unit in 2016, 1.1 gigabyte of data is generating. So due to IoT devices, due to AI and big data analytics and so on. So here we are using fog computing where we can overcome all the things. So we are having different architectures, that is extension of traditional cloud-based computing model, the implementation of multiple layer of network topologies coming into the picture. So what is the benefits we are getting, that is the containerization and virtualization and efficiency. And we are having different pillars, that is security, scalability, openness, autonomy, and RAS, that is reliability and availability and serviceability. So here, if you consider the open fog architecture, so we'll define that is fog cloud and fog to fog in interface. So in this architecture, we are having several advantages, which we terms congestion, efficiency, agility, and latency. So cognition means that awareness of client centric objective to enact autonomy, and efficiency means that dynamically pulling off local unused resources from participating end user device. And then agility means that rapidly innovation and affordable scaling under a common infrastructure. And latency, so people are talking about a latency, that real-time processing and physical that is cyber physical system control. So we are having different platform here, that is platform as a service is characterized of cloud computing services that provides a platform allowing customer to develop, run, and manage web-based applications without the complexity of building and maintaining the infrastructure typically associated with developing and launching an application. So here in open fog architecture, instead to define the required infrastructure to enabling building fog as a service to address certain classes of business challenges. So in this infrastructure and architecture, building blocks have different open infrastructure view. Here we are having different devices, and then it is open fog service, open fog fabric, and the ground level, bottom level, we are having cloud service, and we are having DevOps and security. So if you consider open fog fabric, that is composition of building blocks which allow the construction of homogeneous computational infrastructure on which useful services can deliver to the surrounding ecosystem. So what is the surrounding ecosystems we are having here is devices, protocol gateways, and other fog nodes. So in homogeneous infrastructure is generally built up heterogeneous hardware and platforms supplied by the multiple vendors. And we are having the another open fog service are built on open fog fabric infrastructure. So in this infrastructure, services may include network acceleration, NFV, SDN, content delivery, and device management, and device topology, complex event processing, video encoding, a field gateway protocol, bringing traffic offloading, crypto compression, analytics platform, analytics algorithms. These are different open fog services. And another example of microservice architecture, then we are having different device and applications are edge sensors, activators, and applications running standalone within a fog development deployment or spinning fog deployments. And here this addressed by the open fog service layer. And now we are having another service layer, that is cloud service layer. The advantage of cloud for a computational work that needs to operate on large data scope or pre-proceed the edge data to establish policies. So another layer is we are having the security. So security also one of the most important factor in even in OpenFog consortium. That is, it gives the different security levels. Okay, secure the all the environments. And DevOpens that derived by automated enabled by operationally efficient set of standard DevOps process and frameworks. So here this OpenFog derives a agility of software upgrades and patching, that is patching through control continuous integration process. So here we are having different areas, and if you consider this is the one of the example that is a smart car and traffic control system. So in smart light traffic, we are having different vehicles, and that vehicles are connected with regional fog devices in EMS cloud. Similarly, we are having roadside traffic cameras, and that cameras are connected with multi-metropolitan traffic service cloud and manufacturing cloud, and then will easy to connect. So we are having different opportunities in this smart cities to connected with intelligent hospitals. We are having intelligent cities, intelligent highways, intelligent factories. So we are having different areas where we can use. So if you take the smart cities, so in smart cities what happens, how the people interact, operate within the infrastructure of the city, things and other related information, that is application of fog, open fog architecture. So the open fog architecture can assist in a efficiency of basic city operation, especially for concern around latency, connectivity, privacy, security. So in terms of this, enabled efficient delivery of even more civic services within existing budgetary constraints. So the major issue is in establishing smart cities is availability of ubiquitous broadband bandwidth with the connectivity. So this is a next, you can do lot of research in terms of different smart cities, different hospital, intelligent hospitality. Even you can use the latest the disease, that is corona. So you can use a smart hospital, and you can give different solutions to this area. So then if you consider the agriculture, okay, in the agriculture area, the open fog include either open fog include many, like not only agriculture, meat and dairy production, and hydroponic productions, vegetables, rice, corns, biocrops. Okay, so in many different areas you can adopt this open fog architecture, and in many geographies agriculture is optimized and returns are maximized by large corporate farms. So these farms are already going through the technology revolution to ensure they have to right crop, apply the correct herbicides, this pesticides and herbicides, and maximize the use of the water and the in efforts to maximize profit and yield. So in addition to this, small farms will play an ever increasing role in our food supply as our global population grows. So here's the small farms are also have equal need to maximize the effective use of their resources. So if you consider other applications, that is buildings, so smart buildings. So here the automation in building management in a case study that demonstrate the need for edge intelligence and local processing. A commercial building may contain many thousands of sensors to measure various building operating parameters, including temperature, humidity, occupancy, door open, key card, readers, parking space occupancy, security, elevators, and air quality. So we can use different opportunity, means we are having different opportunity to use open fog architecture. So we are having different pillars of our open fog, that is security, scalability, open autonomy, RAS, RAS, and agility, hierarchy, programmability. So here, if you consider these are the different pillars we are having in open fog. So in this case, what we will do in security, if you take the security, in security what happens, open fog deployments can be initiated on local hardware, migrate across networks, be composed of pure software, or be multi-tenant in nature. So as a result, taking an infrastructure viewpoint, fog nodes and fog layers can be seen in some deployments as fog as a service. Within fog as a service, the location of the layer and node deployment does not always fit within the confines of single data center, but that does not remove the requirement of the security or safety. In this scenario, cloud-driven security or proprietary closed security measures are not always sufficient to protect assets. So from this point, we are having a different infrastructure viewpoint. Both customer and provider of fog services have associated risk to their assets due to distributed data storage and network topology. So in security pillar, start with a clear definition of base building blocks of things. These things must deploy and employ a hardware-based immutable root of the trust. So the root of the trust must then be attestable by software agent running within and throughout the infrastructure. Because of the proximity to end user and locality on the edge, nodes in fog networks can often act as the first node of access control and encryption. So this provides conceptual integrity and isolation and enable the control of the aggregating privacy sensitive data before leaves the edge. So the security implementation have many different descriptions and attributes such as privacy, anonymity, integrity, trust, attestation, and hardware root of trust, verification, and measurement. So these key attributes for fog, open fog architecture. So another main pillar is scalability. So scalability is critical to address the dynamic technical and business needs that drive customer to fog deployment. So here, the great variability in the potential use cases of fog, the reference architecture must enable scale to the usable in the modest size deployment, and then seamlessly go on scale to accommodate the largest, more critical fog networks. So here, the open fog implementation to adapt with the business needs as it relates to the system cost and performance. So here, each open fog node is scale unit of deployment that can run on its own or part of the hierarchical fog fabric. So fabric can be scaled up down in a demand-driven elastic environment. So we are having storage network, okay, and analytics service would be able to scale with the fog infrastructure. So we are having different networks, okay, that is scalable performance, scalable capacity, scalable reliability, scalable security, and scalable software. These are the different components we are having in scalability. So what is scalability performance? That ensure that the scale enable growth of fog instance capable in response to critical application performance demands. That is low latency between sensing reading and resulting actuator response. So what is the capacity of scalable? So it allows the fog networks to grow as more applications endpoints and things, user or objects are added to the network. And what about secure reliability? That reliability at scale permits the inclusion of the redundant fog capability to manage faults or overload, and that a open fog that is having this reliable, available and serviceable ability pillars. And security also, security is a standalone pillar where we can provide the security, and then software that is all. If you consider the open, so openness is the essential for success of the ambiguous fog computing ecosystem for IoT platform and applications. So here we are having different components into this openness, that is composability, interoperability, open communication, and we are having location transparency. So these are different components we are having. If you take the in composability, provides a basis for portability and flexibility of apps and service at instantiation. And if you take the open communication, we have different pulling information pulling into this area. So similarly, we are having different component autonomy, RAS, reliability, availability, service, agility, and hierarchy, programmability. So these are the different components we are having in open fog. So we are these are the different layers, IoT point of view, and the business support. In business support, what happened? It supports the large-scale analytic configuration and business tool management, operational support, that operational analytics and supervisory control, and we are having monitoring and controlling. So here it executes the control loop logic to alter the state of the device based on the sensors and measurements. And we are having different devices. What is those devices? So those are sensor actuators, video surveillance, cameras, smartphones, tablets, okay, and other things. So we are having different IoT development models. So we are having enterprise systems, business support, okay, operational support, monitoring, control, sensor and actuators. So we are having different IoT system development models. So in cloud independent deployment, so here the no use of cloud, that is low event to reaction time windows, and in regulatory compliance, military grade security, provide the privacy and availability of a cloud examples, that is combat system, drone operation, some health smart healthcare systems, and the preparations we are having event to action test windows of operating centric processing pod. Then we are having different use cases, building management, solar panel management, monitoring, retail management. So these are the different. So here in local fog, we are having time sensitive computation in fog, balance of operations and business related processing. We are having different use cases, that is mobile network acceleration, content delivery network, internet. So content delivery network also very, very good topic in this area. You can work on the content delivery network. Okay, so this is also very good area. and then we are having different agriculture connected or remote weather, so weather station. So these are the, so you can use fog layers and fog open, fog in architecture, different applications, so that you can successfully complete all the process. So we are having different so how do we compute the data? Okay, so here we require the intelligence creation. Okay, we are having network edge. From this network edge and sensor actuators will gather the, retrieve the information, and then that information access into the fog nodes or fog nodes, and it data is stored in a cloud area. Recently we have worked on fog architecture, where we are considered as NIT Hamirpur as a one center. Okay, and we are having different nodes, that nodes like hostels, quarter, faculty quarters, and then departments. Okay, so here we are working on power generation, power smart, like we are having different appliances, and from the we can calculate the what is the maximum utilization of power and other things using fog architecture. Similarly, we also work on healthcare levels in healthcare environment also. So we are having a transfusion edge level nodes, we are having, then we are having cloud nodes where we can compute. So here if you take the layers, so oscillators, and we are having connection layer, compute at edge level node, and differently cloud level also you are having. So this is a local communication, how can you can communicate. So first we'll take that these components, that is things, endpoint component, that is the things, devices, and then we are having different gateways. If you see this, we are having building or streets, so these are the fog, and then you can take the neighborhood, which is having the edge nodes. Then you are having the routers, okay, where we are having the global network servers, that is cloud. Okay, so these are the architecture description with the perspectives. So we are having different company application services, application support, nodal management and software backplane, and then virtualizations for open fog node management. Then we can see node security. So here we are having different components, security, manageability, data analytics and control. So these are the different if you see the open fog architecture perspective, so we are having performance and manageability, these are the concern we are having. So functional, if you take the function sensing of sensor, persistent communication technologies, and decision maker system, what are the actuation capabilities, smart devices, and communication through LAN and sensor network, physical. So whatever aspects are having business, the different aspects we are having, business oriented, trustworthiness, and boundaries and life cycles. So these are the security things. So what are the example threats and attacks are available? So if you take confidentiality evaluations, integrity, authentication, availability, and privacy, and we are having the different intents, and we are having different venues, attacks venues. So we are having different attack venues in the insider attacks, hardware attacks, software attacks, network based attacks, and then these are the different intents we are having, leaking information through over or convert channels, modifying the data code without the proper authentication. So we can see the confidentiality level in insider data leakage we are having, and we can have the insider attacks with the integration value, data alteration, password, identity, equipment, and data leakage. So if you see the hardware attacks, hardware trojans, side channels attacks, and we are having radio jamming and bandwidth exhaustions and side channel attacks. If you see software attacks, that is malware, DDoS, DDoS attacks and other attacks. Network based attacks, you can see even dropping messages, transaction replay, spoofing and other places. So this is our lifecycle management lifecycle we are having coming. Okay. So what is the business analytics or business intelligence? So here we are having global applications and local application service, that is FOG, and we are having data that is connected with proper applications. We are having machine analytics, that is. So we are having different components. So in global applications, cloud-based business intelligence, global operational efficiencies, market condition affecting economic predictions. So if you say secure access to the network, so here control the access to the data guaranteed to the enterprise application and to partner. So we are having local service and applications and network-based intelligence. So now we'll have industry 4.0 4.0 visions. So if you see the industry 4.0 vision, the major problem and the major challenging we are having, that is small, we are having smart factories, smart buildings, smart healthcare, smart gates, smart mobility. So when you are coming in this all integrate, then it is coming under the industry 4.0, and we are having different life cycles in RAMI 4.0, that is we are having deployment, maintain usage, production, maintenance usage, and different functions layers, that is business layer, functional layer, information layer, communication layer, integration and assessment layers we are having, and different the levels. Okay, so if you see, these are the products, and then these are the smart device, control device, then stations and work centers. We are having an enterprises all involved in different areas, and it's coming into the industry 3.0, and these are the next generation for the industry 4.0, that is smart products, smart factories, smart connectivity, okay, smart buildings. Okay, so these are different areas we are having. So this is the how to publish and so on, other control layers, and these are the different things we are having. So if you see I want to say, recently we have work on some article that how the cloud computing is working. Okay, so here we are having going to publish in this. So here we are how we can form the nodes. Okay, so when a task are submitted to the fog layer, they gets divided into small size individual tasks, and which are then proceed by the fog cloud fog system, and each task holds the properties. What are the properties? That is instruction numbers, input size, output file, and required memory. Suppose TK specifies TK task, and then the set of n independent tasks sent to the system at each time. So T is called T1 to Tn, and then this the system compromises processors, that is cloud nodes, fog nodes. Okay, which consists of same attributes, that is CPU speed and usage, memory and bandwidth usage. Then these cloud nodes are more efficiently than when compared to the fog nodes, and it is expensive when you are working on it. So the fog nodes is having n equal n union n cloud union n fog. Okay, so that is n1 to nm, where ni represent processing node. So this is a way we can work on how to develop a formulas. Okay, so here if you see the example, so this is, we are having cloud nodes, the other cloud, resource demand, consumptions, and we are having the model, extended PSO model, and that model is using different fog nodes. Okay, so then in that way we are computing up to n tasks with n fog nodes. So this is a way we are compare our method with the different levels, and we got very good results for this article. So you can work on different applications. Okay, like a smart agriculture, smart grids, smart healthcare, smart infrastructure, smart buildings. Okay, so in different way you can work on fog environment, you can work on fog environment by using any model, any technique. You can use deep learning models, you can use when you are developing, when you are working on some particular problem, okay, we are having the application. What is your application? If you consider smart healthcare, okay, smart healthcare is your application, and how you can resolve the things by using fog environment, cloud environment, open fog environment, by using which techniques? So by using machine learning techniques, quantum intelligence based techniques, okay, some basic like different like heuristic methods, okay, means general algorithms, advanced level algorithms. So in this case you can work on it, okay, and you can compliant your solution, so you can success in your problem. So please, any queries, please let me know.
This participant, if you have any query, please ask in the chat box. Sir, I think no any
okay,
query.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving me
your time or sharing your knowledgeable thoughts with us.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much giving this. Thank you for giving this opportunity to deliver and to share my knowledge. Thank you so much. If you are having any queries, please let me know. Okay. If you are having any research collaborations, or if you are having some doubts in while during your research, please let me know. Thank you so much.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Yes, participants, please be on time in next session. That is 2:30. Please join us before 2 minutes.